Good day to us once again. Welcome back to Dexter's World Channel. Today we're going to breed our betta fish. We have so many videos about breeding betta fish, but still many have asked, what is the detailed process in breeding betta fish? Well, of course, I have so many videos and you can browse all these videos. And this is just a supplement of the videos that we have made in the past. We have already paired 10 pairs of betta. As you look at this, these are the new pairs that we are grooming so that we can breed another batch of betta fish. And this is my technique to allow them to get acquainted with each other. And they are here. This is the pair. And I hope they will lay eggs today. This is the first pair that we are trying to breed. And I am glad that the male betta is already making a bubble nest. So another pair is this one. Look at this. Wow. This betta is a crown tail betta, and the female is also here. You look at the female, it's also very nice to see. This is my way of pairing them. I have covered them for them to be acquainted with each other. And this is the third pair, okay? This is the third pair, and I hope they will lay eggs today. Fourth pair is this one. You look at the female, it's really pregnant with eggs. And by the way, these bettas cannot be pregnant, but my term is they are pregnant with eggs already. Okay, since they are not live bearers. So you will see that the female is really smaller compared to the male. Because if you will put a big female bigger than the male, the tendency is that the male betta will be scared. And chances are the female will dominate the male. They have been here for 5 days already. And that's the acquaintance stage that I was telling you about in our previous videos. And the last pair is this one. Okay, so we will proceed to the side of this house. There are breeding containers that I have prepared for them. So we are now here at the 10 containers. I have 10 containers and I also have 10 leaves of Indian almond tree. So we will start our breeding. We will remove the cover of this. And there is no hard and fast rule here because many also have different techniques on how to breed their bettas, how to let them get acquainted with each other. But in my experience, this is one of the most effective way of breeding bettas, this Indian almond tree. Of course, I have carefully washed that one to avoid development of some bacteria. This one is the hiding place under these leaves. The male betta will start creating bubble nest. Okay, many have asked, why is my male betta attacking the female? Well, the answer is maybe they are not yet acquainted, or the female is not yet that ready. So that is why there is no perfect rule here. The moment that you will see your male betta vigorously chasing and hurting female betta, and that's the time that you have to remove the female and give them time to have more acquaintance. Okay, so we will put now the first pair. You look at this. I am using adult matured betta. And this water had been stuck for 5 days now. Okay. So that's it. So that male beta is now ready to breed. Okay, so this female is younger but ready to lay eggs. Because if you will see the bottom of the belly, you will see a white dot, and that's the indication that the eggs are really matured inside the belly, the tummy. Wow, you look at this. We will observe if they will become compatible after the period of acquaintance. So we will observe carefully if they are really compatible. If the female will not go near to the male, and that's an indication that they need more time to getting acquainted with each other. You know, this Indian almond tree is also very effective in controlling bacteria. The moment the eggs are hatched, the flies will receive protection from this kind of leaf, the Indian almond tree. So you will observe carefully now that they are making an adjustment. They are surveying their breeding tank. During the marriage, I call this the marriage because they already have passed the courtship stage, the acquaintance stage. You will expect that there are pairs that really are not compatible, and you have to observe that carefully. This is not perfect. There are really pairs that are not compatible. If the male is really hurting the female, then remove the female immediately and give them time. And if after you have given time they're still not compatible, then maybe you have to select another female. And if still it doesn't work, I would like to say that not all betas are quality breeders. So there are really males that are egg eater. There are really males that are bitter, meaning they really would like to beat the partner. So we have completed putting 10 pairs in these racks. And then another thing is, what we gonna do with this? Shall we leave this open? The answer is no. Because this beta really needs privacy during this time. And look at this one. Female are still scared. The males are adjusting to the new environment. Okay, this is the 10th pair. They are not fighting. Maybe a couple of hours from now, they're gonna lay eggs. So if that is happening, then of course after laying eggs, you will remove carefully the female. And you look at them, you look at them, they are really very compatible now. And the female is going under this leaf, inviting the male now to make a bubble nest. And this one is also having reconnaissance of the area. They are planning now to celebrate their marriage. In the next video, we expect that we can see many eggs in the bubble nest, so that after this one, we will also have a series on how to take care of the betta fry. And this is the common problem of betta breeders. After 3, 4, 5 days, the hatch baby bettas will just disappear. They will die. And what's the technique? We will reveal that in our next video. Hey guys, a pleasant day to all of us once again. You are here back at Dexter's World channel. I promised you that we're gonna have a follow-up of this video, and this is the second series of our betta breeding. And today, we're gonna check this out if we have succeeded in this breeding method. Of course, we already passed the first stage, which is the acquaintance stage. And yesterday, we celebrated their marriage. Yes, and that's my term. And we will see if they are successful in their honeymoons. So we will check the first batch. Okay, this one is quite not ready yet, but they are not fighting, so we can just leave them as that the male is not making too much bubble. So this is an indication that they are not ready yet. We will check the second box. The second box is quite okay. They're successful. You look at that. The male is really inviting the female beta to get near and please come on. You look at this. You will coil that around and squeeze the body of the female beta and extract the eggs out of the belly, and that male beta will gather the eggs and place that in the bubble nest. And this is actually the process. And the third breeding tank is successful already. They already have their eggs, and you look at them. They are creating lots of bubbles, and you will see the eggs right there. The fourth one is, well, this pair is not yet laying eggs, and they are on the process, and they are not fighting, so we can just leave them as it is. We will cover this one. And by the way, they need a lot of privacy when we are breeding this one. And you look at the bubbles are bursting because it is exposed to the air. That is also the reason why we have to cover them to preserve their bubbles. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And what about this one? Is a tragedy. Why? Because the male murdered his wife. Oh, so poor wife. This is it. And this is the reality. We cannot get 100% success of this breeding. So what we're gonna do is we will try to introduce another female, another pair, and we will see if this guy, this male beta, will murder again the partner. Then that is a conclusion that he is not actually a right breeder. Meaning, you know, in life there are also husbands that really beats the wife, and there are failed marriages just like this. The sixth pair is also good. Wow, if you will see that, I don't know if it is clear. The male now is coiling the body of the female and extracting the eggs. We could have a good vision of this process if they had been placed in an aquarium, in a glass tank. What about the sixth one? Well, this is the sad reality. They are not yet compatible, but they already have eggs. Oh my goodness, they have already eggs. So we can conclude that they are a good pair, but I can see that this is not 100% perfect male. Because had he been a perfect male, he should have made too much bubbles. But anyway, we will just observe and we will cover this one. We observe that after a couple of minutes, since we placed female inside the tank, the male really is chasing and hurting. So I decided to place this one back in the bottle, and we will place this one here in the middle for them to give time to know each other better. That's a reality, and it can also be translated to the real life of human beings. You cannot get married if you don't love the person. And many have asked, will you feed the pair while in the process of spawning their eggs? My answer is no. You don't disturb them. After the eggs have been spawned, you will get the female, and that's the time that we will feed the male beta while incubating the eggs. So, but under this process, since they are yet busy spawning their eggs, building their nest, you cannot yet introduce the food. Maybe later. And that's my technique. So our next vlog will be how to take care of the babies, because I believe that 3 to 4 days from now, since the temperature here is warm, this eggs will gonna be hatched, and it will turn into plenty small babies. And the next thing is, will you feed the babies immediately? And what kind of food we are going to give? And this is the content of our third video, third series of this betta breeding. Hi guys, it's a beautiful day once again and you are here back at Dexter's World Channel. We are going to make the part 3 of our betta breeding series, and today we're gonna examine the individual breeding bags and we will check if the eggs are really being taken care of by the male betta. Today, what we're gonna do is we will remove all the female betta to give way to the male betta in incubating their eggs. Well, this is exciting. We will get the female and we will use these bottles for their containers. Okay, the first one is here. Of course, they are already having eggs, but I think we cannot yet remove the female because they are still laying eggs. This one is successful, and you look at this, you look at the eggs. You know, as the eggs will mature on the second and on the third day, these eggs will become yellowish, and that is the sign or an indication that they are really fertile eggs. So to give way to this male betta and for him to get some privacy without any disturbance, we will get the mother, the female betta. And many have asked, what happened to this water? Well, this water has been discolored because of this Indian almond leaves. Okay, we'll remove carefully the female. I said carefully because there are males that are too jealous of the eggs that if in the event they are disturbed, they will eat all the eggs. That's why we had to cover this one, and this is very crucial. You look at that. He is really watching the eggs, making bubbles, and very jealous about these eggs. And what he is doing is actually, he is incubating the eggs. Okay, so tomorrow we're gonna feed this one with live food, but very small amount of it. We will not load this plenty of food, and this is it. They are already true pair, meaning the next time around that you are going to breed them, you don't have to pass the acquaintance stage anymore because they're already a pair. And the third box is here. Well, the eggs are being placed under this leaf and the female is still there, so maybe we cannot yet get the female because they are still together. What about this one? Well, of course we can get this female because she is already staying away from the male. What about this one? Well, of course we can get already the female out of the breeding tank. And again, we have to remove this very carefully because there are really males that are too jealous. So we have removed them and we will place this here. And what about this one? Well, you can get the female because the female is already staying away from the male betta. This is the mother. We will get you out of here. Why we're getting the female? It's because the male is no longer interested with this female, and during the incubation period the male will be pissed off by the presence of this female betta, too jealous. That's why we have to give time to this male betta to take care of the eggs, to incubate the eggs. So guys, we have removed 7 females and we will allow them to recover fast. So we can now give them live food. I'm giving now this mosquito larva. Okay, she's so hungry and wanted to recover from being stressed in spawning your eggs. My technique is give the male betta the privacy, and of course you cannot introduce yet the food. Maybe tomorrow we can feed them, but as of this day we will not feed them yet. So tomorrow we will feed them. Okay, so this is it. This is the third series of our betta breeding, and the fourth series will be the fry already. So we will expect that these boxes will be filled with plenty of small fries, betta fries. And from then on, we're gonna teach you how to take care of the fry. What are the alternative food that we can give to the fry? And that's what you can expect for the next videos. Hi guys, it's a beautiful afternoon and you're here back at Dexter's World Channel. Now today we're gonna check all these boxes if the eggs have been hatched already by the male bettas. So we will check this out. Actually, I have opened already the first box and you will see that there are plenty of babies now swimming, and the father is carefully taking care of them. And maybe you will ask, will you feed these babies immediately? My answer is no. We will feed them tomorrow because they are hatched maybe early yesterday or maybe early today. So the first feeding will be tomorrow. And what we're gonna feed, of course, I have here a BBS baby brine shrimps, and I will teach you on how to hatch this one. And it's also very early to get the father because the babies need some assistance from their father. So tomorrow we will get the father and maybe we'll introduce the first food. What about the second box? Well, of course, the second box is also very successful, and you can see that there are babies also freely swimming, and they are due to eat their first food tomorrow. What about the third box? Well, I cannot see babies on this third box, but the father still under the leaf and there are bubbles, so we can safely assume that there are eggs inside. Well, I can see babies here. This is baby. Wow, there are babies. What about the fourth box? There are so many bubbles here, and the bubbles are already scattered, so that's an indication that there are already babies that are attached to it. So we can safely assume that tomorrow they're gonna swim freely. This is the fifth one, and you know that this is the wife killer. When we first introduced the first female betta, the female betta was killed by this one. We introduced another wife, another girlfriend, and they are successful. And you will see that there are so many eggs down here. So we will not disturb. The babies are not yet freely swimming. So we will cover this back. And what about this one? Of course, you can see babies. There are plenty of babies, but some of them are still hiding and attached to the nest, to the bubbles. So we cannot yet remove the father. What about this one? Wow, this one has plenty of babies and there are no bubbles anymore. So tomorrow we're gonna get the father and then we will introduce the first feeding. The seventh box is also having babies already, and the father is closely watching these babies. Well, this is the first day of the babies. They are hatched today. Earlier today, and maybe last night, some of them were hatched last night, and we will feed them tomorrow. The reason for this is because they are not yet ready to eat the baby brine shrimps. They are still developing their mouth, and tomorrow we can safely feed them their first food. There are still bubbles, but yes, there are plenty, very plenty. And this has the plentiest babies this time. Wow, you can see here. Tomorrow, we're gonna introduce their first food and what kind of food we are going to feed them. Of course, I don't want to feed Dapnya because in other places, Dapnya cannot be catch or you cannot see Dapnyas in other places. So what I am going to do is to hatch the baby brine shrimps because the baby brine shrimps are available in our local pet stores. I'm sure that in your place you can also see baby brine shrimps. But what I have here is 200 grams of baby brine shrimps. It's here. You will see this one. And we will get the half of it, mix this with 1/2 tablespoon of salt. So I have prepared a button for this one. So we will divide this into half. And I'm using a funnel. So we will put this one, half of this one. Okay, maybe it's already half. And then we will put 1/2 tablespoon salt. I'm using the refined salt. So the salt is there. And we will erate this one. I am using this 1 liter. This is 1.5 or 1 liter. I think this is 1 liter. And I made a small hole on the cup. And we will connect this one directly to the hose. Our next video will be the feeding of the betta pride. You know, in breeding bettas, the feeding is one of the most significant. It's crucial because if we feed prematurely, then it will cause death. If we also delay the feeding, it will also cause death. And after this, we'll receive their first food on the following day or on the third day, we're gonna transfer them to a bigger container. And in the manner of transferring is also very crucial. Why? Because you have to make sure that your water is really that condition. Hey guys, it's a rainy day here in the Philippines and you're back at Dexter's World Channel. Well, today, as I promised you, we are going to give the first food of the betta fries that we have produced. Yesterday, we were able to show you that these boxes have many babies. Yes, we will examine this if there are still babies. And of course, we are so successful about our hatching of this baby brine shrimps. We will examine if these brine shrimps are already good for feeding. And one indication that these brine shrimps are already hatched is this one. These are the shells of the eggs. And if you will detach the aerator, you will see that the tiny living organisms can be found inside and they are already very active. Yesterday, we were talking about the first feeding, which is very important. And this is what we're gonna do today. Another question is, shall we remove the male betta from the breeding containers? The answer is, it depends. We have to determine whether the male betta is no longer making bubbles. So if he is not anymore making bubbles, that's an indication that the babies can survive without the father, like in this case. In this case, you will see that this baby betta are swimming freely and some of them are already very independent because they are no longer attached to the bubble nest made by the male betta. And the question is, are we going to get this male from the breeding tank? My answer is, it's too early. Not yet. What about this one? Of course, this one has the same case. You can see bubbles and babies are still getting near to that bubbles. So it's too early to get the father, the male betta. What about this one, the third box? Wow, the third box is here, and you will see that there are also many babies, but under the sleeve there are still bubbles, so they still need the father. And the fourth one is here. You look at this one. Though some of the babies are swimming freely and they are independent, but some still needs the care of the father. So it's not yet practical if we will remove the father from the breeding tank. What about this one? Remember this one? This is the wife beater, the killer, but you look at this, he has plenty of babies. The second pair is really very successful. Well, I can see bubbles, so we will not yet remove the father. About this one, yes, you cannot yet remove because there are bubbles. And this one is different because the babies really are already very independent. So, in this case, we will remove the father because we have notice that the babies are already freely swimming and they can survive on their own. The question is, shall we introduce the first feeding today? The answer is yes. It's a big yes. We can now start feeding this betta. What will happen if we will not feed? Of course, this betta will die. So if we will feed out of time, meaning if you will delay the first feeding, you will note that these tiny babies will just disappear and our breeding will become a failure. And you look at our brine shrimps. Well, the brine shrimps are really hatched. I believe that 100% of them are already hatched. This contains large number of baby brine shrimps. To get the pure baby brine shrimps, we will use the hose. Once you have hatched your brine shrimps, the technique to extract the babies apart from the shell is to siphon them. You look at this one, so tiny. And you will eat your first food. Okay, good luck. You eat that. You know, baby brine shrimps is more safe than dapnya because this is clean. Considering that the source is clean, and you cannot expect that there are bacteria because this is hatched also with salt. Many have asked, what is the alternative of the baby brine shrimps or dapnya? Well, many have said you can feed the egg yolk, but I haven't tried that. And the best thing really is this, brine shrimps and dapnya. Well, many have said you can also powder your pellet and give that to the small betta. Well, I would not advise, because I have tried that using pellet or these prawn feeds, but it ended up a failure. So we have no choice but to really hatch brine shrimps or dapnya. Well, many have said, what about microworms? I haven't tried it. What I have tried is this one and dapnya. 3 days from now, we will transfer this one to a bigger container. And as what I have said, that the manner of transferring is really very important, because the moment that we will commit a mistake, especially on the kind of water that we are using, it will also result to the death of this baby bettas. So we will condition the water, we will put some Indian almond tree, and of course we will ensure that the temperature of the water from here to the bigger tank is really the same, because if we will commit a mistake, the temperature will vary, then of course it will really cause the death of this betta fish. I Hey guys, today we're going to update you with our beta breeding. And this is the sixth video that we have in our series. And today we will get all the male beta out of their boxes. Well, we will see first the first box. And this first box has plenty of beta babies. You look at that. And since the father is no longer taking care of the babies by way of creating a bubble nest, so we will decide now to take out the father out of this breeding tank. And we will carefully remove the father so as not to disturb the babies. Wow, congratulations for a job well done. Wow, there are plenty. Look at this one. Plenty of babies. Wow. And the third one, well, there are bubbles. And still taking care of the babies by means of creating bubbles. But the babies are seemingly very independent now that we can safely remove the father. Other breeders will just allow the father to stay for more than 10 days or even more than 10 days. But in my case, since I am feeding brine shrimps, I decided to remove the father on the 7th day. Well, it's a case-to-case basis, but normally on the 7th day, the babies can already survive without the assistance of their father. Them. Clean water, and we will start feeding now. We will not put plenty, just a small amount of it. We will not put plenty because the moment this baby brine shrimps will die in this container, it will cause the development of bacteria and it will kill our baby beta. This is the second feeding. We have removed already the fathers. They're here, they're flaring. Today we're going to transfer our beta fish babies here in this container. This is a bigger container and I made a preparation 5 days ago about this tank. I've gathered some plants and treated this water with the leaves of the Indian almond tree. And of course, you can see here now that there are boxes that are being placed in here. Well, I just allow them to float, and 2 o'clock dawn, I placed these boxes that are filled with babies of betas, and the purpose of which is to ensure that there is the same temperature. The temperature here would be exactly the same temperature of the water of this bigger tank. Many have asked how many days you're going to transfer your babies from the breeding tank to a bigger tank. Well, it all depends. If you will see that the babies are already swimming freely, independent, and can survive in another container, that's the time that you're going to transfer. And you will witness that this container is filled with babies of this beta. And you will note that the water is already green. As what I have said, this is an old water, more than 5 days, maybe on today is the 6th day. I am pretty sure the temperature of the water in this small tank is the same as in this bigger tank. So we will closely monitor this one and we will put some water from this bigger tank inside this small breeder container just to make sure that they will not be shocked by this new water. And this is very important. I've always said in my videos that this is crucial. You may have been very successful in the stage one, the acquaintance, the breeding, the marriage, and even the hatching of the fry. But the most crucial is this one. When you are going to transfer, you cannot transfer just very easily. You have to prepare. As what I have said, I have to repeat this. You have to prepare an old water conditioned with Indian almond tree. And of course, the water should be free from bacteria. You will note that I only transferred 2 boxes. I cannot put them here all together because this is gonna be crowded. Okay, the water is dripping now out of this box. Okay, very carefully. Can do this one. Come on. Like that. Just like that. And you will note that this is already green. I have here plants and the babies are eager enough to get out. Get out! You get out! Yes, 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 yes. This environment is suitable for betta, but we have to cover this one because we cannot just allow the temperature to really become warm. So we'll cover this one after this. So guys, we have transferred just 2 boxes of babies, and there are other, I think, 6 boxes that are just right there, and due to be transferred in a bigger tank also. But this is the final video, and I hope you will get some tips, lessons out of our video. And of course, I'd like to thank you all for supporting us. We have experienced many good comments, suggestions, and even constructive criticisms. And you can also share your ideas as long as it will help our viewers, the new beginners who wanted to, you know, breed also betta fish. So thank you for watching. I hope you like and share our videos, and you will continue to support us and continue to view our upcoming videos. And if you haven't yet subscribed, please do it. Hit that notification bell and subscribe to our channel. Only here at Dexter's World!